Championship.
Congratulations, coach. I just told Shane
played about as great a college football game as I've ever seen.
They were so persistent. They just destroyed the passing river tonight.
Well, I think our defensive coach did a super job getting the kids ready. And I came up with the big plays. I've done that now for 2 years. They're a great bunch of kids.
You've won a lot of big games, but this is the biggest one.
Well, it's one of the biggest ones, certainly. We've had a lot of luck in our life, and I've been fortunate to be around a lot of great young people and great coaches. And I just thank the good Lord for everything he's given me.
All right, congratulations, coach. You guys are number one.
Exactly a year later, and Penn State capitalizes, upsetting Miami, which had been a touchdown favorite. The Nittany Lions have a second national championship. You remember they got one a few years ago with a Sugar Bowl victory to climax a big season with a win over Georgia that gave them the national championship on that occasion. This is the 100th season of Penn State football, and they celebrate that century of excellence with a national title tonight. Vinny Testaverde unofficially threw for 285 yards, but of course he had the 5 interceptions among 7 Miami turnovers. What do they say about Schaefer? All he does is win. 66-1 since the 7th grade. Only the Orange Bowl loss last year against Oklahoma. Schaefer was just 5 of 16 for 53 yards, had one intercepted, but he comes out on the winning side. Penn State with the national championship, 14-10. We'll be back with more from Tempe, Arizona in just a moment.
Shane Cowan for Penn State with 2 interceptions and 8 tackles. Alonzo Highsmith for Miami, 18 carries. He runs for 119 yards. Each player will receive a special trophy in honor of his achievement in tonight's game. And some kids will donate $2,500 to the General Scholarship Fund of Penn State in Miami in their name. The final score, Penn State 14 and Miami 10. And I think it'll be said time and time again, the way to win the national championship is on the field like we have seen here.
So I think this makes a big call to the NCAA for a national championship game to be played each and every year. They begin their convention this coming week in San Diego, and I think many people are saying, I hope they finally realize this is the way to win a national championship by playing on the field.
Well, again, defense wins championships, and we saw it here tonight. 2 good defenses, and you've got to give your credit to Joe Paterno and his staff for coming in and stopping Vinny Testaverde in that offense, stopping him cold, 5 interceptions and 7 turnovers.
Well, I don't want the loss to be the end of the world for the Miami King. They had a great season. They had a tough time tonight against Penn State. And you know that ball club, and I understand they've got a couple of young quarterbacks that could be just as good as Vinny Testaverde.
Well, they are. They're a young ball club, and they'll be back. But I think what we talked about early, and that is Joe Paterno wanted to get inside of Testaverde, so they were a little bit confused, getting rattled a little bit, and you had some problems. And it happened last year in the Sugar Bowl against Tennessee. And I think it happened here again this evening. Quarterback, when you're playing that style of defense, can't do it all himself.
What about Penn State? They just continued it up.
They do. Penn State had 17 fifth-year seniors, and to a man they said that we all decided to come back for our fifth year, walking out the Orange Bowl field last year after being beaten by Oklahoma. They felt to a man that they could win a national championship, and they saw the dream come true tonight.
It has been the Sunkissed Fiesta Bowl, the final once again. It is Penn State, the national champion, defeating Miami by a score of 14-10. For Bob Breese, Jimmy Semple, I'm Charlie Joe. Let's go to Bob Costa, huh?
And all that remains now, Charlie, is to say goodnight. A national champion has been crowned. That championship belongs to the game to the Penn State and the Nittany Lions. John Schaefer heading off. Following the 14-10 victory, these are unofficial numbers, but in terms of total offense, Miami had 445 yards to just 152 for Penn State.
A season to remember is over now in college football. Thousands of games played, a few individuals honored, a new national champion crowned. But the curtain also comes down in a different sense tonight. We focus on the headliners and the pro prospects, and we forget that for many of these participants, it's the end of football. The end of an essentially youthful experience. They move on now to careers and responsibilities. Time passes. The memories last.
This is the time.
Still wearing those battle fatigues, they went to war. Jerome Carter sacks John Schaefer. Turnover, Miami recovered, and the Canes were fired up early. Miami took over and ended their drive right here. The handoff goes to Melvin Broughton, and Broughton flies over the top with a touch. Miami had the early 7-0 lead. The Lions charged back hard. They put together a 12-play drive, and it was kept right here. John Schaefer with the football. He rolled right. No receiver, so he's going to keep it. He got a good block. He just made the corner of the end zone for the touch. Tied at 7 at the half. In the fourth quarter, the Hurricanes were deep in their own territory with a 10-7 lead. Just a good back to pass. He used a big play, but he got it for Penn State. Conlin picked it off. He had two interceptions. He went to the end zone here, but he stopped short. The momentum had switched in favor of the Nittany Lions. The icing on the cake was provided shortly thereafter when DJ Dozier got the call, and Dozier went up the middle behind some great blocks, and it was 14-10 in favor of Penn State. And Coach Joe, well, they were heading for the national title. Miami put together a late-game drive, and Vinny Testaverde was the man in the spotlight. He had four interceptions going into the closing seconds. Make it five. The pass was picked off by Pete Gastopoulos, and that was the ball game. Penn State and head coach Joe Paterno win the national title. They beat Miami. The final score, 14-10 in favor of Penn State, 9-6 by Miami. We hope you enjoyed our local and national Fiesta Bowl coverage. Let's go back to Tempe, where Lou Tilley is standing by. And Lou, as I mentioned, lots of turnover tonight. But overall, I thought both clubs went at each other pretty hard.
That's quite a light. There's going to be a lot of bumps and bruises tomorrow for both clubs, but Penn State's going to wake up with smiles on their face. You can bet that. And take a look at this scene, Mickey Washington. Joe Paterno nailing down his second national championship in 5 years, being carried off the field by his players. And just listen to the sounds, including Eddie Johnson, local guy from Lindenwall, New Jersey, and John Schaefer, as they react to the Fiesta Bowl and the national championship. Listen.
Here's Playhouse, Phil. Praise God.
Well, look at this now. Back here live, Tom Brookshire, Chris Conlin, Delaware Valley product, offensive tackle. Oh, my goodness, what a game.
It was unbelievable. Our defense played outstanding. When we come into the game, we thought we were going to win, and we did.
And the big play now, Tom, down on the goal line here. I guess it was, what, second and goal from about the eight? And they busted off that big right side. What'd you do there?
I down blocked on Osilio, number 93, and they kind of drove him to the ground. And Morgan pulled right behind me and kicked out the end, and DJ got in.
Hey, looking at some of the defensive plays right now, so
you really showed me something. I didn't know he had that much lateral movement. He was absolutely great tonight.
Yeah, DJ's quick. Those Brock shoes.
Were they tougher defensively than maybe you thought they were going to be, Chris?
Looking at film, we knew that they were going to be tough and quick, come on the ball.
What are you thinking right here? Vinny had the last chance to score on your defenses back then.
I couldn't believe it. You know, they were down here like on the 30 or something. He was driving them down, so I was like, oh no, you know, Vinny's going to do it again.
Would you better believe he gets 6 takeaways against that offense of theirs? I couldn't believe it either.
I couldn't believe it either. Our defense, like I said, defense is great.
Hey, Joseph, I mean, you were having some trouble in the first half handling that big guy, Jerome. He's running all over the place. And at halftime, you said, we got to do something to handle that guy.
Yeah, well, we kind of came out and single blocked him, but after a while, we started double teaming him. And then he didn't get too much into the backfield.
What's going on back in that locker room right now?
It's unbelievable. People are going nuts taking pictures there. And but that's something on me.
And we appreciate it. Thanks for coming out here. Joe,
congratulations, Chris. Of course, from the Delaware Valley. And Tommy Brookshire, again, to recap before the game. You thought they'd have the edge, and they sure did.
I thought both teams would score a little bit more on that, but it really doesn't make any difference. 4 points is 4 points.
Now, what everybody's going to talk about tomorrow, of course, is the interception.
That you think Miami.
We're trying to forget about that. Well, you know, we said that, and I said that if Miami scored first, then Penn State would have problems. Well, they did. They came back and won anybody. Anyway, and people are going to say, Vinny, did he choke, Tom? I mean, is it that simple?
I don't think so. I think they gave him a lot of different sophisticated defenses. I've never seen linebackers get good drops like Colin and the guys were doing that. They really did. They had great drops, and they gave him a lot of new stuff underneath.
A couple times when he threw it to Conlon out there in the flat, there wasn't even anybody from Miami. Were giving Penn State that well prepared? They were anticipating routes?
Yeah, I think so. I think Paterno, with the extra week or so, could prepare for a big player like Testaverde, like he's done in the past. You know, he took away Marcus Allen, and he's taken away Herschel Walker, and he took away Testaverde.
Rookie, it was a fun football season for you, huh? We started it off, kicked it off in the preseason with the Eagles, and here we wrap it up with a beaut.
I'm wondering if Buddy Ryan might go for Colin as a linebacker instead of Bosworth.
Well, if there was any doubt, that he's a high in the top 5 picks. I think Chris Conner, or rather, Shane Conner
should
have tonight.
Yeah, I know.
Rookie, I enjoyed it, all right? I'm buying the Coronas. I got it raw. Penn State on top. We'll see you back in Philly. That's the story, live. From Tempe, Arizona. Yugi?